Virgil just told me that he chose boxing.
Oh yeah, yeah. So I never got to go to stuff because I was on the IEC probation.
How old were you? 15, 16?
I think it was from 14 to like 18.
Oh wow, that's serious.
Yeah.
4 years.
I was in the street, so I was doing stuff I shouldn't have been doing. And this time I didn't do anything. My friend did it. I just didn't snitch him out. I just didn't snitch him out. I should have. You know why? I wouldn't even say snitch. I should have just said, this is my, because he let me fall for something that he knew was his, and he
should have coughed up.
Would have went up and said, wouldn't let one of his own homies go down for something he did. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But anyway, long story short, so I would go train, and I was actually gonna go pro. And we'll bring my son to the gym. And one day I just I took him, and then I go, hey, you want to spar? And he just said, yeah. And he didn't know what sparring meant. So I threw him in there, and I still remember to this day. It's like it didn't like he had some sort of technique or nothing.
But he hit hard. You can't teach it.
Well, he hit hard, you know. But he had this. I don't know how to explain. It's just like. The will, the instinct to hurt the guy or the kid as he's throwing it. It wasn't just like, oh, I'm thinking. It's just one of those like, don't come, like he, it just, he had it in him.
Good seeing you again. Good seeing you again. When are you leaving?
3 weeks.
Oh, okay. He's fighting in England next.
Oh, shit.
27 and 0, right? 29 and 0, my bad. 29 and 0, that's impressive.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, very talented kid. So Virgil's the natural.
Natural, like the getting it, that's natural. Yeah, he's naturally at it. So so then I just said, you know, I'm gonna put him in boxing. I played a lot of ball, and no matter how good I was, if a guy next is taller than you, even at pickup game, we're looking at the guy that's taller than you, no matter what. Until you finally show up in sports. That's too much of a disadvantage.
Yeah. That's true. You're right. Size.
You know, the opportunity can cost you your opportunity.
Correct.
So as a guy, off of judgment, off of somebody thinking that you're not very good enough for it.
And then you don't come to the right school, the right coach, the right reference. They're going to pick the guy that...
You know, and football is dangerous already. And you got a lot of coaches out there that are coaching that don't know anything. I mean, like, really don't know anything. And it's more dangerous because these guys are going head-to-head with their body weight. And I know this because, some of the guys that coaches, I knew from school, or they're my friends. Some are my friends. I wouldn't say, like, my friends.
Yeah, but you know them. Acquaintances.
I hear them talk at the barbershop, and they don't know anything. They think it's funny. And, man, they're playing with the kids' fucking brains and shit.
A lot of concussion. More kids die from football than boxing.
Well, boxing the most safe, is like, the top two safest sport in the world.
Yep.
Yeah, the guys die in pro here and there, but how many kids die in football from
much
just
more,
even practice?
More and more
a
than boxing. Yep.
A lot of them die.
That's
now,
true.
This is a sadder sport because at the end, these guys get left behind and
some have brain damage and so
they,
on. Yeah.
They have to invest their entire life. It ain't like they can do this and then go have a job. Some guys barely can, but even those guys aren't very good because you gotta live this
time. No social life. It's 365, 24/7. You can't go to school, you can't have a day job, can't develop a career.
Look, football you can eat all day and get big and
yep.
up to the one. This one, this sport you can. You have to watch your weight. You gotta, you can't take timeouts. Like, you're fucking hurt. And the other sports that you're hurt, you gotta replace.
Substitute, yeah.
Different, man.
Not only that, NBA, you're injured, you're guaranteed contract for the next 3 years. Boxing, you're injured, your contract's frozen.
No, not even that. In boxing, if you lose a fight,
you're fired.
You can get cut. You'll get cut. They have the whole advantage.
Or a draw.
Yeah, or a draw, or and even if you win, sometimes guys are won. They win just so they can be this next guy's
mandatory
opponent, so that way they can lose to that guy. So just because someone wins over here, I mean, sometimes you're being spoon fed to this guy, don't even know it. It just goes like that, man. So you have to take care of yourself.
But Virgil, my prediction will be a world champion this year. He's 21 on 21 knockouts. He's supposed to fight August 10. We're waiting for the official announcement, whatever, and that will make him, if everything goes well, interim champ. And then The rest is 154, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I hope so, man. He Vergil earned it. He definitely has earned it. I mean, he's worked hard and he never took any short shots. He's lived this sport. You can tell just by how he's able to, you know, do everything he does. And, I mean, 21-0 and 21 knockouts. You could be spoon-fed and not get that.
Of course, nobody gets that.
Because if not, everybody would have it.
Correct. It's only him and Bitterbive and Tank, I think, with those kind of percentages, right? Who are undefeated with 21-0. Like, Tank's 30-0, Bitterbive 20-0. Other guys may have a lot of knockouts, but they have a couple losses. Yeah, which is nothing wrong with getting
some
a couple losses.
Some guys have all knockouts, yeah. But they have a loss.
Yeah, though. And that's part of boxing, but it's more unique when you're a perfect record.
Yeah.
So guys, there you have it. Make sure you follow at Vergil Ortiz, at Vergil Street Senior, at Hector Beltran Senior, and big news coming soon. Okay. Stay tuned. Okay. TheEssNewsReport.com and Melly Setback Reporting.